Danes se res krasno počutim, vikend je pred nami in danes smo tako radodarni, že smo podarili en prstan in ja, danes bomo podarili tudi vstopnico za prihajajoči jutrišnji Inspirit kongres. Jaz se blazno veselim, tudi sama bom na samem kongresu namenila nekaj besed, govorila bom o tem, ali je možna duhovna rast ob medijih, torej če spremljate televizijo in podobno, ampak bom kar malo zakrila vsebino, ki jo bom zaupala. No, na temu kongresu se bo predstavilo z svojim izjemnim delom kar nekaj ljudi, ki prihajajo iz treh držav, tako da krasen dogodek in jutri, če imate čas od 9:30, pa praktično do 10:00 zvečer, ne, mislim, da poteka vsa ta stvar, tam bo tudi naša ekipa, tako da bo krasno. Tukaj z nami v naši družbi in pri vratih, lepo pozdravljeni.
Dobar dan, hello, dobar dan.
Welcome. Nice to meet you. Dobar dan, potem pa kar naprej. I'm kidding that all this week, every day I'm translating, every day I'm talking English, so yeah, it's good, everything is okay. Torej, v naši družbi iz Nemčije, you're from Germany, right?
Yes.
Yeah. Torej, iz Nemčije prihaja medij in pa zdravilka, so you're a healer and medium.
Yes, that's right.
It's a really important life mission that you're that you're playing, but you communicate with souls.
Yes.
When did you first get aware that these are souls? Did you have like a visit or something like that? Torej, vprašala sem, sorry, I need to translate to our viewers. Torej, vprašala sem, ona komunicira z dušami, ne? In tukaj me zanima, kako, kdaj se je prvič začela zavedati vseh teh duš in kdaj so one začele komunicirati z njo. So, when was the first time that you, like, whoa, this is something not from Earth?
Yes. Actually, when I was 5 years old, so mainly I would see the deceased ones, and but it started when I was 2 or 3 years old. My father told me already, I was just telling, you know, or saying crazy things like, you can't enter the living room, it's already filled, can't you see it? And so it started by seeing the deceased ones and by hearing them. So I was clairvoyant and clairaudient also. And
so you see and hear them?
Yes, and feel them.
And feel?
So, yeah.
So like they are like living persons?
Actually, yes, it's a little bit different. When I was able to see them as a little child, I saw them as I can see you. This side changed. So I can see them in the aura field and I can see them from an inner side.
Torej, zaupala nam je, da pravzaprav z dušami umrlih komunicira že od nekaj let starosti, da kot otrok je zmeraj govorila, lej, pa ne moreš iti v dnevno sobo, ne vidiš, da je že polna. Skratka, videla jih je tako, kot vidi žive ljudi, ne samo videla, tudi slišala in čutila. Zdaj sicer vidi v avričnem polju in vidi mogoče mečkeno drugače, ampak takrat je bilo to, kot da bi bili živi ljudje.
If you look at the average person, we have many souls with us living all the time and we don't really know, right?
Yeah, yeah. Every human being has a guardian angel, for example. Every human being has spirit guides and also, of course, the deceased ones, the beloved ones, they have a look at people. So, yeah, every human being has it. Even if a person doesn't believe in it, the guardian angel is around, so it doesn't make a difference.
Torej, veliko stvari se dogaja, za katere mogoče mi niti se jih ne zavedamo, niti ne vemo, niti ne vidimo. Gre se za naše osebne vodnike, ki so z nami, angele, ki nas verujejo in ves čas obstaja cel svet, ki je mogoče našim očem trenutno še ne vidim.
Very interesting. Do you feel a presence right now? Because I can feel something.
Ah, see, that's nice. You always will feel angels around. And sometimes I see a person and I see the angel around. I see the head of the angel or something. And I might say to the person, you know, now you might sense something. You might sense a warmth or you might sense a tingling or something like that. And so I make them aware of, you know, they are around and you can sense them, of course.
Torej, vprašala sem jo, če tudi sama čuti pozornost, oziroma če je nekdo tale trenutek z nami, ki ga ne vidimo, ne, ki ni v take fizični obliki, kot smo mi. In je seveda pritrdila, da ja, da velikrat tudi vidi in angele, vidi vodnike in jih celo prosi, da to osebo mečkano požgečkajo oziroma da opozorijo na se. That's nice. So, on the Congress tomorrow, you will do your special thing. You will communicate in live audience, with live audience.
Yes, I'm gonna have some platform work, and I'm gonna connect with angels and spirit guides and the deceased ones. So I give a live demonstration on the work. Yeah,
that's amazing.
Yeah.
Torej, na jutrišnjem kongresu, za katerega bomo danes podelili tudi vstopnico, le komu. Veliko se bo jutri dogajalo, med drugim pa bo tudi demonstrirala, kako to delo pravzaprav poteka. Namreč komunicirala, povezala se bo namreč z vsemi angeli, z vsemi dušami, tudi tisti, ki so preminuli in se pravzaprav povezala z občinstvom in občinstvo potem v živo dejala in zaupala kakšne stvari, tako da to zna biti zelo, zelo zanimivo. Komu bomo podarili vstopnico, me prav zanima, kdo bo tisti in skrajno se veselim torej jutrišnjega dogodka. So we have like a case, let's say. The viewer's husband died, unexpected death. He didn't have time to say goodbye or anything. She can feel him, she can smell him and things like that. But she wants him to go. What can she do? Torej, imamo en primer gledalke, ki je umrl mož, popolnoma nepričakovane smrti in še vedno ga lahko čuti, sliši vonja, kakorkoli že. Želi pa, da bi se torej poslovil oziroma to jo mečkano tudi straši, kaj lahko naredi.
See, there's always a reason why a deceased one is connecting. And it might be the reason of not being able or weren't able to say goodbye. Or there's the reason of unanswered questions. Or there's a reason for, you know, freeing people up of feelings of guilt, for example. And it might be from one side or the other side. So maybe her husband wants her to get to know something. So she could connect from soul to soul telepathically and ask him what he wants. And if there's any open question for him, you know, and then ask him to leave her. But I think most likely they have a reason to knock on the door, you know. So she should find out about the reason.
Torej, odgovarja, da vsekakor obstaja razlog, da se to dogaja in duše preminulih pravzaprav zmeraj z namenom komunicirajo, zaradi tega, ker ene stvari enostavno še niso razrešene. Še ni čas, da bi se torej poslovil, ni imel časa, da se poslovi in nekaj se enostavno mora zgoditi. Tako da tukaj se lahko telepatsko duša poveže z dušo, kjer se potem pridobijo pravzaprav ta vprašanja in tako lahko pride do razrešitve, da tudi ta moški lahko nadaljuje, gre v svetlobo in pa tudi sicer. Takole, že čez nekaj trenutkov bomo sprejeli tudi telefonski klic za karto, ki bomo torej podelili karto, se veste, kot smo tudi govorili. Tale trenutek pa mogoče še eno vprašanje. You have this special gift. Is it like hard to live with it?
For me, no, not really.
No, it's because, a way of life.
Because you see the results, you know. So my job is about to give comfort to people and to help them to overcome their fears or feelings of guilt. And by doing so, I also see previous lives. And by doing so, they are able to get an understanding why different circumstances occur in their lives, why they have difficult relationships or whatsoever. And in order to overcome them, this is to understand the situation. And by understanding, they can forgive persons involved in a situation or themselves. and so they can change life for better, you know. They come to a life of peace, of joy, of happiness. And that's what makes it easy when you see the results. Even if a difficult situation is there, you can, with the help of angels, you can lead them to what is actually important for the soul itself. What the soul, what the aim of the soul actually was, you know, and it's like about the life mission. And once they understand, it's very easy for them to embrace life again.
So it's a rewarding
yes,
mission
it is,
for you.
Yes, it is. Yeah, and of course you feel with them, you know, you watch the scene and you sense it, but I'm able to let go. Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Okay, that's emotional, intelligent.
Yes.
Turbo.
That's true.
Torej, Andreja je odgovorila, da ja, s tem darom, torej, da lahko komunicira s svetom, ki ga sicer mi ne vidimo, da je življenje zelo zanimivo, predvsem pa tudi nagrajujoče, kajti tukaj se dogaja pravzaprav ogromno, predvsem, ko vidi rezultate, kaj vse se lahko zgodi. Ljudje se lahko na ta način spremenijo življenje, spremenijo pogled, tako da je zelo, zelo odgovorno delo in je zelo, zelo tudi nagrajujoče. Vsak trenutek bomo torej sprejeli tudi tale telefonski klic, kar se tiče tele vstopnice. Še predtem pa, mogoče tole me res zanima, da ne bom pozabila, And so the 1st of November is coming. Mm-hmm. Is this the time where the souls of the past ones are maybe more restless?
I don't think so. They are always around somehow. And they are using... like I'm also giving private readings or evidential sittings. And even if a person is just asking for a life situation, deceased ones will take the chance to talk with this person, you know. So it doesn't depend on a special date or a special month or whatsoever, in my experience. Mm-hmm.
Torej, vprašala oziroma zastavila sem vprašanje, kako je s 1. novembrom, ki se približuje, ali so takrat duše malce bolj nemirne in odgovorila je, da so duše pravzaprav vedno povsod oziroma vedno okrog in tudi pri njenem delu, ki obsega zelo različne storitve, ki jih torej ponuja tistim, ki želijo kakšno vprašanje več in odgovore, torej jih mogoče drugje ne morejo dobiti, da pravzaprav se ves čas lahko komunicira, tako da niti ni tukaj nekih ne vem kakšnih težav oziroma ne vem kakšne priložnosti zdaj, ki jo prinaša sam 1. november, sicer pa lahko pri svojem delu vidi tudi prejšnje življenje, tako da lahko dejansko ponudi zelo, zelo veliko informacij. Mi pa imamo tale trenutek na telefonski liniji že našo nagrajenko, mislim, da bo nagrajenka in sicer bo gospa Ivica. Lep dober dan želim.
Lep dober dan tudi tebi, Jasmina, in seveda tudi gospe Andreji.
Najlepša hvala, kako lep glas imate.
Ja, malo sem prehlajena, ampak sem prepričana, da bom jutri pa že v izvrstni formi.
Bi rekla. Imate kakšno vprašanje za današnjo gostjo?
Vprašanj bi bilo kar precej, se pa tudi sama povezujem s temi energijami, angelskimi energijami in mogoče jo bom pa jutri kaj poprašala. Zdaj bi pa tako rekla, čutim tudi sama to energijo gospe Andreje, krasna energija in vem, o čem pravzaprav govori, ker tudi sama pogosto občutim to. Mm-hmm. Tako da,
kdaj ste
res
se
sem
pa...
vesela.
Kdaj ste se pa vi začeli povezovati z angelskimi svetovi?
Kdaj sem se začela? To je pa že kar nekaj let. Čutim iz mladosti, tako kot je gospa rekla, 3-4 leta, 5 let je bilo zelo intenzivno, ko sem bila stara 5 let. Potem kasnej v letih to nekako daš kar malo na stran, a ne? Uh-huh. Potem pa znova pride obdobje, ko to tako intenzivno začutiš, da ne moreš več tega zanikati.
Ampak je bilo verjetno... Verjetno niste razlagali to ljudem, kaj vi čutite, pa kako ste. Ste se kdaj bali, da si bojo mislili, da ste nori, pa da ste za vojni,
ja,
pa kaj?
Ja, res je tako. Zdaj je sicer tako, zdaj so te angelske energije moderne, a ne? Ampak tisti, ki so pa mene predčasno že poznali, so povedali, kaj čutim in so potem tudi z mano delili svoje izkušnje, svoja spoznanja, svoja videnja, kar mogoče 15-20 let nazaj res niso mogli nekomu povedati. Zdaj pa to zmeri več tega in prav je, da ljudje postajamo odprti, da govorimo o tem, kaj čutimo in dejansko to je to odpiranje čustov, odpiranje srčne čakre in ta čista brezpogojna ljubezen, kar je tudi bistvo vsega.
Gospa, jaz mislim, da bo organizatorjem in Spirit Kongresa v čas, da bo tudi takšna duša, kot ste vi, prišla na tole eksplozijo svetlobe, ki jo torej jutri pričakujemo v Austria Trend Hotelu, tako da vsekakor z veseljem, vstopnica je vaša in pocukajte me za rokav, ker ne vem, če vas bom med vsemi ljudmi spoznala, no?
Neskončno sem vesela, ker ko sem pač poklicala v studio, sem si pa čisto iskreno zaželela, če je to moje najvišje dobro, če angelčki želijo, da mi bo to naklonjeno, se bo zgodilo tako in točno tako je tudi bilo.
No, evo, pa se je zmanifestiralo.
Ja.
Najlepša hvala, evo, kar bravlince sem dobila, najlepša hvala in pa iskrene čestitke. Se vidimo jutri v živo.
Se vidimo, hvala.
Pozdravljeni. She said a lot of things that she has like her own experience with doing work with angels and really, really, really nice lady. Mm-hmm. She will have some questions for you maybe tomorrow live.
Great.
So we're really looking forward to.
Yeah.
Okay, what else can we expect tomorrow?
Yeah.
Do you like let yourself go and whatever happens, happens?
Yes. So I'm guided by guardian angels or spirit guides or the deceased ones. And it might be also the case that I would see a previous life in order to help somebody. You know, it's like with this lady, you know, I can feel or sense something also from the voice. I could already sense that she's like a sensitive person. Mm-hmm. And immediately I saw her angel coloring, or the angel that was colored in blue and telling things like she's very, very patient with other people. So she's doing a lot with other people, but she has, so the angel was saying she has to listen to herself and she has to take care of that a little bit more, to take her space and her room to do so.
Jaz so it's tako like, srčno upam, da tale gospa govori angliško, zaradi tega, ker upam, da bom tole vse. Torej, Andreja je začutila tole gospo in zaupala, da je takoj videla vse te njene angele, ki so ji govorili, kako zelo je potrpežljiva, kako dela z ljudmi, kako je srčna in izjemna in da mora začeti poslušati tudi sebe in slediti torej svojim sporočilom. Sicer pa od Andreja lahko jutri pričakujemo marsikaj zanimivega. Včasih pravzaprav je vodena od zgora, ampak včasih se zgodi, da tudi vidi pretekla življenja koga in takrat seveda v danem trenutku to tudi pove, če je tako namenjeno oziroma če se to lahko zgodi, da s tem lahko tudi drugemu pomaga. Wow, really amazing. How do you feel Slovenia?
Well, we just arrived yesterday, so I can't say anything about it. But I feel the nature is very important also for the people here, and I loved to be at the nature. And I think the Slovenian itself, themselves, and they are very open also. Mm-hmm. And, you know, it's like everywhere in the world, people are searching for what actually their hearts, they want to have fulfilled hearts and they are searching for that. And that's in Germany, that's in Slovenia, this is in Ireland, this is all over the world. And this is also my message, you know, you just have to go inside, you don't have to search outside.
Make a
it's
step inside.
It's your heart, yeah, it's your heart that wants to be fulfilled and is the heart itself has all the joy and all the peace. You just have to go inside. Mm. So,
hvala lepa. Thank you very much to be the host today, to be very looking forward to tomorrow. Zaupala nam je kar nekaj zanimivih takih blagih besed. Upam, da ste jih začutili. Vsekakor se bomo jutri torej videli izživo s tistimi, ki boste na Inspirit kongresu. V nadaljevanju pa še malce klepetanja in tudi zanimive preproste nasvete imamo pripravljene za vas. Tako da je super fino in fajn. Thank you again.
Thank you,
thank you very much. And stay with us. Torej ostanite v naši družbi tudi v nadaljevanju.
Thank you.